So in the voltage shunt feedback amplifier, we are going to discuss about the input resistance with feedback and the output resistance with feedback. So in case of your voltage series feedback amplifier, we have used the two important blocks. One is the operational amplifier block and the other one is the feedback circuit. So here it may be connected in a shunt feedback, that is a parallel connection, the feedback circuit. So in this, where in voltage series feedback amplifier, the op-amp and the feedback connections are connected in series. So in case of the shunt, it is connected using a parallel connection. So there we have used a feedback resistors of the resistors are R1 and RF. Here the only component resistor feedback is used is RF. So here we have used only the one resistor factor. So this, in this circuit, we have already, I have mentioned, it's an operational amplifier with a gain A and the supply voltage plus VCC and minus VE is given to that operational amplifier, and we have the two differential voltages V1 and V2, that is nothing but your VID, and here that non-inverting terminal is to be grounded. And here the input terminal, so the input is given to that inverting amplifier which drives the circuit via the resistor feedback, that is your RF feedback resistor. So here we have used only a RF resistor as a feedback circuit. So this RF factor is a feedback circuit. So this is the circuit. Usually we draw an operational amplifier with an inverting amplifier at the top and the non-inverting amplifier at the bottom. Here they have given a connections to that input to that inverting amplifier. So they have made this terminal to the change the terminals, negative and the positive, and the V1 to be grounded. So in case of this, I have drawn it an equivalent circuit. So here again it's a gain A, then non-inverting terminal as such it is grounded here. So again I have made this non-inverting terminal to be grounded, and the current flow through this, I have mentioned it as IB1. Usually there won't be any current flow in this operational amplifier in case of my ideal operational amplifier. So now I am applied a Vin voltage, that is your input voltage is connected in series with your resistance and the RF is a feedback resistor circuit. Here the current flow is IB through the resistor R1 and the IF through the resistor RF. So this is the circuit. I have made it in general the inverting at the top and the non-inverting at the bottom. So this circuit we can call it as an voltage and feedback amplifier or the inverting amplifier with feedback. Inverting amplifier with feedback. Okay. So this is the basic circuit diagram of that voltage shunt feedback amplifier. So based on this circuit, we are going to calculate a closed loop gain AF. Closed loop gain and that input resistance with the feedback, and the output resistance with feedback. And other than this, we are going to calculate about the bandwidth with feedback and the total offset voltage with feedback. So these are the things we have discussed in case of your voltage series amplifier, feedback amplifier too. So in that voltage series feedback amplifier, we have used R1 and RF as your feedback circuit. So now we start with the closed loop voltage gain. So in the closed loop voltage gain is normally represented in terms of the notation AF. So we will define that AF in terms of the ratio of output voltage to that input voltage. So we have to find the output voltage by the input voltage. So based on the circuit, the V naught is from that output path and V in towards that input side. Okay, now we have to derive the V naught and Vn in terms of this R1 RF resistors and the feedback currents and the base current. So initially I am going to apply a Kirchhoff's current law equation to obtain the gain AF of that voltage. I am going to use a Kirchhoff's current law equation. So now I am going to find the equation. So here I am going to express for this voltage V in, here the voltage across the connected to that inverting is V2. So between this V in and V2, the resistance. So I can write according to Ohm's law, V is equal to IR. Now I am going to express the terms of current equation. So my current I is equal to V by R. So I should write my expression in terms of voltage and resistance. So here the V in and between V in and V2 we have the resistance R1. So here I can write my expression V in minus V2 divided by R1, which is equal to, we have to frame for another one, right? So here I am writing V equal to V2 minus between the V2 and the V1 naught voltage, the resistor, feedback resistor is there, V naught divided by RF. Okay. So in this case, so we know as usual that VEID is nothing but the differential input voltage, VID is equal to V1 minus V2. So in this condition, I am going to choose this VID is, it's a open loop gain V0 by VID. So in this VID I can replace as VID is equal to V0 by A. So instead of that VID I can replace that V0 by A, which is equal to V1 minus V2. So in case of this V1, it is connected to that non-inverting terminal, that is to be grounded. So I am going to substitute my voltage V1 to be 0 volt. So in this condition, I can make V0 by A is equal to minus V2, or it implies V2 is equal to minus V0 by A. So V2 is equal to minus V0 by A. So now I am going to substitute this value in that expression. So make it this expression in a box. So I know that value now, V0 is in terms of the output voltage, V0 by A. So I am going to replace that V2 instead of V2, I am going to replace minus V0 by A. So here in this expression, so V in plus V0 by A divided by R1, which is equal to minus V0 by A minus V0 divided by RF. So I am going to make it an alignment, V in plus V0 by A divided by R1 is equal to taking minus V0 as common. So 1, I am reframing this side, 1 plus 1 by A. So I can write this as ARF into this ARF by RF. So I can write 1 taking minus V0 as common, taking as 1 plus 1 by A divided by RF. So don't get confused, I'll be again writing it, rewriting it. So individually I'm writing V in divided by R1 plus V0 by A into R1 is equal to minus V0. So I can take it as minus V0 of A plus 1 divided by ARF, right? So again, V in by R1 is equal to minus V0 of A plus 1 divided by ARF plus 1 by AR1. So again I can take Vn by R1 is equal to A into RF and R1 as common. So I can write minus V0 of A into RF. So I can write R1 plus A into RF. So I can write AR1 plus RF. So I have to rewrite in terms of V0 by Vn. So making this V0 to that other side and Vn to that other side. So I am keeping my V0 as such, V0 divided by Vn. So it comes minus A into R1 RF divided by R1 into R1 plus RF plus ARN. So making R1, R1 gets cancelled. So I can write my expression V0 by Vn is equal to minus ARF by R1 plus RF plus AR1. Okay, this is the exact expression for this closed loop gain. So now we are considering this R1 and RF value will be very less and when compared to this AR1. So in that condition V0 by Vin is equal to minus A into RF by AR1. We will get that A and A term gets cancelled, which implies V0 by Vin is equal to minus RF by R1. This is similar to your inverting amplifier gain. So coming to that, this is the final expression of that closed loop gain. So the closed loop gain expression is V0 by Vin is equal to minus A into RF divided by R1 plus RF plus AR1. Okay. So now I am going to calculate how in case of your voltage series amplifier, I am going to write the expression as AF is equal to A by 1 plus AB. Similar to that, I am going to find the expression in terms of the closed loop gain to be expressed in terms of your open loop gain and the gain of the feedback circuit. So here I am going to divide the numerator and denominator by R1 plus RF. So this is the factor. So in that condition, V0 by Vin is nothing but your AF, closed loop gain, your minus A into RF by R1 plus RF. This R1 plus RF make it as a one term. So you can get it as 1 plus that AR1 alone is divided by R1 plus RF. Okay. Now I am going to make this A into AK plus divided by 1 plus AB. So here this RF by R1 plus RF is taken as the K and this R1 and R this is taken as the B. Okay. Where K is the voltage attenuation factor. And the voltage, the letter B represents the gain of the feedback circuit. So in case of that voltage series feedback amplifier, we get AF is equal to A by 1 plus AB. So in case of this closed loop gain of that voltage and feedback amplifier, the closed loop gain AF is equal to minus A into K divided by 1 plus AB. So this K is nothing but your voltage attenuation factor. So coming to that topic called inverting input terminal at virtual ground. So here every input terminal, the inputs are connected to that inverting input terminal. So here we are making that to the virtual ground. So I am making that V2 voltage that is also to be grounded. So in this condition, what will happen? Again, we will apply a Kirchhoff's current law in the equations. So in this, we are going to find the current flow and the differential input voltages across this voltage V1 minus V2. Then we have to find the gain of that inverting input amplifier using a feedback circuit, that is nothing but your closed loop gain. So in this condition, your Iin flows to Ib and If. So your Ib is nothing but it passes through the R1 resistor and If it passes through the feedback resistor. So coming to that point, we have Ib current is very less in case of this inverting input terminal because the Rin is very large. So in that condition, so I am going to make that Iin value is almost equal to that feedback resistor. So in this expression, again I am going to write Vin minus V2. So in this again, Vin, the same expression to be written, Vin minus V2 divided by R1, which is equal to Vin minus V0 divided by Rf. So in that differential input voltage, V1 minus V2. So already I have mentioned that V1 is connected to that non-inverting input amplifier that is to be grounded. So now I have made that inverting input terminal to a virtual ground. So this in this condition, I am going to make my V1 and V2 to that zero. So here V1 and V2 is applied to that 0 volt. So here I am going to substitute the V2 as 0 volt. So in that condition, Vin by R1 is equal to minus V0 by Rf. So again I can write V0 by Vin is nothing but your minus Rf by R1. This is the gain of your inverting amplifier and this is the gain. AF is equal to minus Rf by R1. So the next topic is input resistance with feedback. So here we are going to apply a loss signal model. So in this concept that inverting amplifier with Millerized feedback resistor. So here we have made this Vin and the input resistance value is made 0 ohms. We are going to introduce two Millerized component, two components in terms of resistor feedback circuit. So here this Rf by 1 plus A is one component to be introduced at that input side and the Rf A by 1 plus A, it is the another component. So in this we are going to introduce one at that input side and the other component at that output side. To in this input resistance, it's easy method to calculate the value of that input resistance. We all know that Ri is the input resistance and the Rif is the input resistance with feedback. So in this condition, so consider this, this voltage L is connected with the resistance R1. Now it is connected R1 and Rf by A is connected in series with this input side. These two resistance and the voltage is grounded and the resistance is also grounded. Then it is connected to the input resistance Ri and the loss signal model. So in this connection, these two R1 and Rf plus 1 by A divided by 1 plus A is connected in series and it is in parallel with the resistance Ri because all the resistances are at the end to be grounded. So in that condition, this Ri is in parallel with these two resistors. So in that condition, I can write my expression Rif is equal to R1 plus Rf by 1 plus A, which is in parallel with Ri, right? So in this resistance, the Ri is very large. The value is very large and similarly the gain is also high. So in that condition, if this is become parallel with this, it gets very small value in that concept. So I am going to make the RIF value is equal to RF, because that RF by 1 plus A, see, the gain is very high. That means if you substitute that infinite value to that gain, so in this condition 1 by infinite is gives a zero value, approximately a zero value. That will be in parallel with RI, it's again a zero value. So I am going to take the expression, the inverting input amplifier with input resistance with feedback is equal to the resistance R1. So one thing here, the new factor introduced is the Millerized component. So here introducing an RF by 1 plus A is one of the resistor at that input side, and that output side we are going to introduce RF into A, which is nothing but the gain of that operational amplifier is multiplied with that resistor RF A by 1 plus A. Coming to that output resistance with feedback, so this is your operational amplifier. That inverting amplifier gets grounded, and the V2 terminal is connected with the Vin supply, and it is to be shorted. So it the R1 and RF are connected in series. This voltage shunt feedback amplifier of this non-inverting is similar to that voltage series feedback amplifier as a connected to that inverting. So in that condition, there we might have seen that expression ROF is nothing but RO divided by 1 plus AB. This is the gain 1 plus AB. This is the output resistance with feedback is calculated. So the same concept here we are going to apply a Thevenin's theorem concept. So coming back to that I naught, we are going to remove that supply. So by looking forward, we are going to calculate I naught is equal to Ia plus Ib. From that, we are going to calculate that resistance. This derivation is already, we have derived in that voltage series feedback amplifier, and the resistance with feedback, output resistance with feedback is calculated as R0 by 1 plus AB. So both non-inverting terminal or the inverting terminal are identical in this case of this voltage shunt and voltage series feedback amplifier according to output resistance with feedback. So the next topic is bandwidth with feedback. So we have already discussed about the bandwidth with feedback in case of the voltage series feedback amplifier. There we have defined the unity gain bandwidth is equal to F into AF, sorry, F naught into A. This is your open loop gain, and F naught is the frequency bandwidth. This is like a gain bandwidth product. Similarly, for this UGB, unity gain bandwidth is for the feedback resistor, it is will be multiplied with the closed loop gain. So now we are going to derive, we know the same expression that feedback resistor feedback of bandwidth is given as F naught into 1 plus AB times F. So this is the expression we got in voltage series feedback amplifier. In that condition, we are going to derive in terms of our voltage attenuation factor and the gain of the feedback circuit and the open loop gain to find that closed loop gain. Okay, so here that FF, I can make it F naught. So here, one second. Yeah, the F naught is the break frequency of that op amp. F naught is the break frequency of the op amp. So I can make it F naught is equal to unity gain bandwidth divided by the gain A. So similarly, I can make it for FF, unity gain bandwidth divided by AF. It's the closed loop gain. So from these two expressions, I am going to classify in terms of the gain A and F. So in this condition, I am going to replace this closed loop gain, equating those two. AF, we know that A by A into 1 plus AB. This is the final expression to be derived. So based on this, we are going to reframe this expression in terms of that K, B and A for AF. So already I have mentioned that AF can be written, expressed in terms of your open loop gain and the gain of the feedback circuit. Now we have introduced a new factor called voltage attenuation factor. So here I am going to rewrite FF is equal to UGB into K and divided by AF. So we know that K is nothing but your RF by 1 plus, sorry, R1 by RF. In case of your B is represented by R1 divided by R1 plus RF. When substituting, you will be getting this as an expression, because AF is nothing but your minus A into K divided by 1 plus AB. Once you substitute this value, you will be getting that feedback of your bandwidth. Okay. So the next comes the total offset voltage. So the total offset voltage with feedback. So this we might have studied in the voltage series feedback and the DC characteristics. Initially we'll apply that input voltage to the 0 volt to make our voltage, output voltage to 0. So in that condition, if we didn't get the output voltage as 0 volt, then we are going to introduce a small voltage at that non-inverting amplifier. That non-inverting amplifier with the voltage called VOS. It's a small offset voltage is connected to that non-inverting amplifier terminal. The same condition there we apply to that voltage series feedback is the total output offset voltage is equal to, this is like an offset voltage with feedback, is equal to total offset voltage divided by the 1 plus AB. So this offset voltage can be represented in case of the V saturation, that may be at a positive or negative values. So here it may depends on the power supply and the temperature. This is the final expression, V saturation. So VOT, that is nothing but your total offset voltage, is similar to your voltage series amplifier, and your bandwidth with feedback, the relation is similar to that voltage series feedback amplifier.